So what is a ferret?
Carpet shark.
Floof noodle.
Cat snake.
Noodle bear. Mustelid putorius furo. At least that's their scientific name. The word ferret itself in Latin means little thief, which they definitely represent. A lot of people actually think they were domesticated from the wild black-footed ferrets. However, they were actually domesticated from the European polecats. A lot of people also think they're related to rodents, like rats, mice, or even guinea pigs. Ferrets actually come from the Mustelidae family. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong, forgive me. And that comes from the Latin word mustela, which means weasel. Being part of the Mustelidae family, they're actually related to weasels, polecats, stoats, badgers, otters, martens, minks, and wolverines. Animals in the weasel family have long, slender bodies and shorter legs. And they're also carnivorous predators. So just like other mustelas, ferrets are obligate carnivores. Looking at their teeth, as well as their digestive tract, also proves this. This is super important when it comes to the diet of your ferret. The best diet for your ferret is actually a raw, yes, raw, meat diet. Now, it's also important to note that if you're doing a raw meat diet, it's so important that it's a balanced diet. Otherwise, it can actually be pretty bad for them. Ferrets are crepuscular, meaning they're active at dawn and dusk, and they usually just sleep the rest of the day away as well as the night. Unless they're descented, ferrets can actually release their anal gland secretions if they're scared or excited, just like what a skunk does. Health-wise, ferrets are actually very prone to tumors, and especially adrenal disease and insulinoma. It's especially common in the United States, where ferrets are unfortunately mass-produced in mills. As for lifespan, they tend to live 7 to 10 years of age. However, there are those that can outlive 10 years, and unfortunately there's a lot that actually die before 7 years of age. So why were ferrets domesticated in the first place? For ferreting, of course. Ferreting is just a word that means hunting with ferrets. So because of their long, slender bodies, these guys were perfect for getting inside the burrows and holes made by rabbits, moles, and other rodents. And they would either flush them out, and some would even kill them. There are some countries that ferrets are still used for this purpose. Ferrets eventually made their way into being pets. However, there's still a lot of places they're considered illegal. So make sure you double check to make sure they're legal if you want to own a ferret. Some terminologies when it comes to ferrets. A male ferret is called a hob. A female ferret is called a jill. A spayed female ferret is a sprite. And a neutered male is a gib. Baby ferrets are known as kits. And a group of ferrets is known as a business.
As for size, ferrets can greatly vary in size. Anywhere from 1.5 pounds to 4.5 pounds. Now, I have seen some people post that they got ferrets that ended up being 5 up to even 5.5 pounds. 1.5 to 4.5 pounds is the average, not the rule. As you can see, all of our boys are all around 2.5 pounds. Now, for telling what gender a ferret is, we're just gonna flip Hagrid over here. That is not a belly button. If your ferret has one of these, it's definitely a boy ferret. If they don't have one, they're definitely a girl. And your girl ferrets are definitely going to range in those smaller weight categories as they are usually much smaller than the males.
Ferrets also come in a ton of different colors now. You have cinnamons, which are like reds. You've got champagnes and chocolate-covered ferrets. I just said chocolate-covered ferrets. Don't eat your ferrets. You have champagne or chocolate colored ferrets. There are your traditional sable colored. There are white ferrets that have the red eyes, the albinos. You have white ferrets that don't have red eyes that are known as dark-eyed whites. You have silvers, which Winky, I'll include a photo, but Winky used to be a dark silver color. Usually the silvers will actually do what's called roan out, where they almost turn into a completely white ferret. So there's a good chance eventually he'll be completely white because he used to be almost completely dark silver. So now you know what a ferret is. Now you have to decide, is a ferret right for you? In our next two videos, we're going to talk about the positives of owning ferrets and the negatives of owning ferrets. So if you want to be notified when we put those videos out, definitely hit that subscribe button and then hit the little bell so you get notified when those videos go up. Hope you enjoyed our video today.